Welcome to all. Here, I am going to teach you the CHO 150 course, Basic Organic Chemistry. In that course, last time we learned about the carbocation, which is a reactive intermediates. Today, we are going to learn the second part of reactive intermediate, that is carbanion. So, let's start our topic with the carbanion. What is the carbanion? Carbanion is an anion in which the carbon has an unshared pair of electrons and bears a negative charge, usually with a 3 substituent for a total of 8 valence electrons. Formally, the carbanion is a conjugate base of a carbon acid. How to form a carbanion? Here you can see in this RCH group, by removing the hydrogen, there is a formation of the RC minus. The carbon having a negative charge is called as a carbanion. The stable carbanion do, however, exist, although in most cases they are reactive. Here, the carbanion is pyramidal shape and sp3 hybridization. Let's we learn how it form a sp3 hybridization. Okay, here the carbanion which have, that means the carbon having a negative charge, that means the valence electronic configuration of a carbon is 2s2 and 2p2, but here in this case the carbon having a negative charge, that's why the valence electronic configuration of C minus is 2s2 and 2p3. Okay, that's why here the ground state electronic configuration is 2 electron in 2s and 3 electron in a 2p. In a hybridized state, here these 2s orbital and 2p orbital, these are combined together and there is a formation of 4sp3 hybrid orbital. These 4sp3 hybrid orbital which have a one lone pair, this have a one lone pair, and here the 3 unpaired electron of the carbon is combined with a unpaired electron of a hydrogen, like this manner. And there is a formation of a sp3 hybridized orbital and the geometry is a tetrahedron. Here their geometry is a tetrahedral, their shape is pyramidal because of their lone pair of electron, and the bond angle is 109.28. Okay, here it has a 8 electron. How it got a 8 electron? Because here the hydrogen 1 electron and the 1 electron of the carbon. Here there are the 3 hydrogen which is combines with the 3 unpaired electron of the carbon. That means there is a formation of the 6 bond pair electron and 1 lone pair. 6 plus 2 is 8. That means it has 8 electrons. Here this can be stabilized by resonance and the inductive effect. Let's we see, this is the structure of the sp3 hybrid carbanion having a lone pair of electron. Okay, let's we learn the stability of a carbanion. Here first, the electron donating group destabilizes the carbanion while electron withdrawing group stabilizes it. Here in this case, the NO2 group is attached to here, which is the electron withdrawing group, and this is electron withdrawing group, and here OCH3 which is electron donating group. Here electron donating group is destabilized, that's why here this compound it is less stable than the electron NO2 containing carbanion compounds. Okay, NO2 group is the electron withdrawing group, and that's why it stabilizes the carbanion, and here OCH3 is the electron donating group, and that's why it destabilizes the carbanion group.
next is the inductive effect. The stability of alkyl carbon ion can be explained by an inductive effect. Greater the number of alkyl group shows plus I effect attached to the carbon atom bearing a negative charge, lesser is the stability, because their inductive effect increases the negative charge density on the carbon. That's why here the primary carbon carbonion is the more stable carbonion and the tertiary one is the unstable. Why? Because it shows a plus I effect, and due to that plus I effect it increases the charge density on the carbon, and that's why the stability of this carbonion is going to decreases. Here their stability of the carbocation is totally opposite to that. If you ask the stability of the carbocation, that time the tertiary carbocation is a very stable carbocation. But if you ask the carbanion, that time here the tertiary carbanion is a more unstable carbanion. Why? Because it shows a plus I effect, and due to the plus I effect here it shows the inductive effect which increases the negative charge density on the carbon, and that's why here their stability is going to decreases. And that's why here the in case of carbanion, the primary carbanion is more stable than the secondary carbanion and then tertiary carbanion, which is very unstable carbanion. Next effect is resonance. The carbanion is stabilized by a resonance. If a double bond is located alpha to the anionic carbon, due to the delocalization, negative charge diffuses over whole molecule and thus the stability increases. This explains the stability of the allylic and benzylic carbanion. Okay, as the resonating effect increases, their stability of the carbanion also increases. Why? Because the delocalization of a negative charge diffuses over the whole molecule, and that's why the stability is going to increases. Here this is CH2 minus group. Here there this negative charge is shifted to the ring, and that's why resonance which happen, and this negative charge which is delocalized into the whole molecule, and that's why their stability is going to increases. Okay. Next is what the some characteristics we learned already. Here this hybridization of this carbanion is sp3, geometry is a pyramidal like this. It shows the 8 electron outermost orbit of carbanion. Carbon has octet is completed. It behave a charge nucleophile. Okay, here the carbocation which acts as a electrophile, and this carbanion which is acts as what? Nucleophile. It is a diamagnetic in characteristic. Okay, all because of all 8 electron are the paired. It is formed by the heterolytic bond fusion and it react with the electrophile. Why? Because here the carbanion is acts as a nucleophile, and that's why which is react with the electrophile. Here this is some comparison of the structure of the carbon. First, this is a carbocation. Carbocation, that means it contains a empty p orbital. Here in case of carbanion, it that means carbon having negative charge, it contains what? Lone pair of electron. And in case of methyl radical, which we learn afterward, which contains the one electron in a p orbital. Okay, here what is the comparison according to the hybridization? Here the carbocation which shows sp2 hybridization, it contains empty p orbital. In case of carbanion, it showed sp3 hybridization, but it contains the lone pair of electron in a p orbital. And in case of methyl radical, it contains only one free electron in a p orbital. Okay. Next day we are going to learn, that is free radical chemistry. First we learn carbocation, Second, we learn carbon ion, and let's we start to learn the third reactive intermediate, that is the free radical. The free radical can be defined as the chemical species or atom or the molecule that has one or more unpaired electron in a valence shell. As a free radical contains an odd number of electron which make it unstable, that means more reactive. It can be react quickly with other compound, trying to capture the needed electron to gain the stability. Here, in this case, you can see it contain a one odd electron here. Okay. Let's we learn some free radical are stabilized by the resonance. The geometry of free radical is generally that of the shallow pyramid. This means the partially filled p orbital can participate in a resonance with adjacent p orbital, leading to a greater stability. Okay, here you can say the allylic free radical is more stable than the simple or propyl free radical. Here the cyclohexane free radical is less stable than the benzylic radical because of what these are included in a resonating effect. Here also the free radical are more stable if they are highly substituted, like the carbocation. Here the tertiary free radical is the more stable than the secondary, which is more stable than the primary, and which is more stable than the methyl compound free radical. That means as the number of R group is increases in a carbon, their stability is going to increases. Next, we learn their hybridization. Here the carbon radicals is sp2 hybridized and trigonal planar, like sp2 hybridized carbocation. The unhybridized p orbital contain a unpaired electron and extend above and below the trigonal planar carbon. That means what happened here? The carbon radical, that means it contains two electron in a s orbital, and here the two electron in a p orbital, only one electron. Okay, and what happened here in hybridized state? This electron is goes to the p orbital, and then what happened in hybridized state of the carbon radical is like this: one electron in a s orbital and three electron in a p orbital. But what happened here? Only two hydrogen which is combines with three hydrogen is combined with the three unpaired electron of the carbon, and there is a formation of sp2 hybridization. And here it remains one unpaired electron in a p orbital, which can be shown in this diagram. The p contain a single electron, and that's why here it shows a sp2 hybridization. That's why it shows a trigonal planar structure or a geometry, and that's why here they has the bond angle 120. This is about the carbon radical. Here this is the hybridization of the free radical. You can see here the carbon, which is the valence electronic configuration is 2s2 and 2p2. But what happened in a hybridized state? What happened? The two electron of the s is excited to the p orbital, and there is a formation of hybridized state, three electron in the p orbital. But what happened here? The three hydrogen of having one electron in combined with the three unpaired electron of one s orbital and two p orbital, and there is a formation of three sp2 hybrid orbital and containing one unpaired electron in a p orbital, and there is a formation of a trigonal planar structure containing one unpaired electron. Here this is a structure of the carbon free radical. Here three hydrogen are planar forming a trigonal planar structure, and one unpaired electron or odd electron which is present in the p orbital. This is the hybridization of the free radical. Thank you very much for watching this lecture. Next time we will learn another reactive intermediate. Thank you.